على مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Once again, greeting you, a hearty greeting to all the respected and beloved viewers of ITV. May the Almighty Allah shower you all and your families with His choicest blessings and His eternal glory. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. On this wonderful day of Ramadan, in this glorious month of the holiness and sacredness of Ramadan, we once again focus on one of the beautiful gems from the gems of the Quran, and this gem is known as Surah Yasin. In fact, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam refers to this surah as Qalbul Quran, which means the heart of the Quran. Now that in itself speaks volumes about this gem of the Quran, because the heart is the most important component of our makeup. If that heart is right, the whole body is right. If the heart is bad and corrupt, the whole person is corrupt. And the heart is that component, that part of the body that pulses and causes the blood to flow to all the veins and parts of the body. So we need a healthy heart for a quality life. So important is this understanding of this surah of the Quran, which is known as the heart of the Quran. And can you imagine, respected viewer, if my and your heart is connected to the heart of the Quran, how beautiful the pulse of our hearts will pulsate, the remembrance of Allah, the greatness of Allah, and extolling His divine greatness. This surah commences where Allah addressed the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to many scholars, by saying, Yasin, O Yasin, which many understand that Yasin is one of the names or titles of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And therefore, out of love for the surah and love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, many parents call their children and give their children the name Yasin. And Allah say, "Wal Quranil Hakim," I take an oath by this glorious Quran. Almighty Allah in His divine majesty take a divine oath by His divine speech, Al-Quran, and say, إِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ عَلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِينَ. Most certainly I vow by my divine majesty, Allah say, that you are truly one of my righteous prophets, one of my true messengers. عَلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمَ. You are indeed on the straight path, O my Rasul, giving consolement, giving comfort, and giving assurance to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the veracity of his prophethood and about the divine aid that Allah is always with him. If you study this beautiful surah, Surah Yasin, the heart of the Quran, so many numerous lessons can be learned. But Allah throughout the surah, one of the most focal points Allah makes mention of is the reminder of the inevitable day of judgment. The day when every person from Adam to the last person that must still be born into this physical abode, we will all stand in the divine supreme court of Almighty God Allah. And one ayat in the surah where Allah says, وَامْتَازُ الْيَوْمَ أَيُّهَا الْمُجْرِمُونَ. On that day when the whole mankind will be assembled in the presence of Allah, it will be said to mankind, O you sinners, stand aside from the righteous ones. Can you imagine the announcement, the divine announcement that, O you sinners who live in the disobedience of Allah, become separate. Allah will bring about a division between mankind, the righteous on the one side, and the unrighteous and sinners will be moved onto the other side. If you look at great pious people, like Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayh, the great Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayh, these people were regarded as great scholars, spiritual luminaries and saints from Allah. Yet when people like these read these verses, they used to cry. Tears will flow from their eyes. A person asked Imam Abu Hanifa once, why is it when you read this ayah, you always cry? He say, I am afraid that I might be in the company of those or in the group whom Allah will say, oh, you sinners, you stand separate from the righteous people. This is true humility. And it is this kind of humility that we must imbibe in us. Not self-righteousness, not self-acclaimed piety, not Jannah is only reserved for me, paradise is only reserved for me. No, we must have love for ourselves, yes, but love also for every human being, be they Muslim or non-Muslim. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God, speaks further about this day of judgment, when we will all stand in His divine supreme court. And Allah knows, because He is our creator, that by nature we are very argumentative. We like to rebel, we like to argue, we like to debate. And even on that day, we would want to debate with Allah. But Allah says, الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Allah say, on that day of judgment, you will not be able to argue. No correspondence will be entered into, because نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ, I'm going to put a zip on your mouth, Allah say. You will not be able to speak. وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ, your hands will speak to me, Allah say. وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ, and your feet will bear witness for you or against you. You know, people are very skeptical at times and they say, but how is it possible for our hands to be able to speak and our feet can speak? It's amazing if you look at the science of reflexology. People touch your feet and it's like your feet can speak to them. They can identify exactly what is wrong with you or where your ailment lies, because the feet speaking to them. So what stops you from believing that Almighty Allah will make your hands to speak and your feet and your legs bear witness against you or for you, in favor of you, for the places that you have walked to? If you walk to places of ill repute and places that are not good, where the disobedience of Allah is taking place, verily your feet and your hands and your body will bear witness against you. But if you walk to the masjid, you walk to the synagogue, the church where you worship God, you walk to holy places, sacred places, where you interact with the presence, the ever divine presence of Almighty Allah, then surely I believe your body and your body parts will bear witness in favor of you on the day of judgment. And then Allah Almighty so beautifully reminds us and say, وَلَوْ نَشَاءُ لَطَمَسْنَا عَلَىٰ أَعْيُنِهِمْ فَاسْتَبَقُ الصِّرَاطِ فَأَنَّا يُبْصِرُونَ. Allah say, in your arrogance and your rebelliousness, call to mind my favor of the eyesight that I have given you. For I have the power to put a peel over your eyes and snatch away your sight in a split second. Can you imagine that if Allah must leave us in darkness, total darkness, where you cannot see anything around you, no more you are able to enjoy and see the majestic sunrise, or see the spectacular sunset, or see the raging oceans, or see the multicolored flowers and the beautiful chirping birds. You cannot see anything. You live in a total state of a dark world. We can hear its sounds, but you cannot see it and enjoy it. So Allah said, remember, I am the one who have given you the sight, and I am the one who can take away your sight. Appreciate your sight and ask those who are blind who cannot see, and they will tell you, if only God can return my sight, that I can look and see his numerous favors and appreciate his bounties and the beauty of his creation. And then Allah also tell us to focus on another aspect. وَلَوْ نَشَاءُ لَمَسَخْنَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ مَكَانَتِهِمْ فَمَسْتَطَاعُ مُدِيَّوْ وَلَا يَرْجِعُونَ Allah said, if I wanted to, I could have caused you to become paralyzed in the position that you are in right now, and you will not be able to move to and fro. You will not be able to move forward nor backwards. So every movement, every interaction, to be able to stand up, to walk, to run, to hold, to touch, to feel, is the bounty of the precious bounties of our loving Creator. Surah Yasin mention all these that we can reflect, that we can take a lesson and bask in the glory of Almighty God Allah and thank Him forever for all His favors that He bestowed on us in this world and that is awaiting for us in the eternal life in the year after. May Allah cause our hearts to become connected to the heart of the Quran, and may we draw ever closer to Almighty Allah. Until tomorrow, I greet you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
نورٌ على مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا به للصالحات وللمكارم والتقى نورٌ على مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى